So today's video is about WordPress dashboard. I'm going to show you all the options available in WordPress dashboard, that how you can manage your website, how you can manage content on your website. And if you'll follow all the video, in the end, you will have a very good understanding about WordPress dashboard. I really appreciate if you like the video, you can subscribe to my channel and you can share with your friends and family who are in process of making their own website or who just want to learn web development. So without any further ado, let's go into the video. So this is my WordPress website, and to log in into admin panel, you need to copy your website URL and add /login in the end and hit enter. It will take you to the login page where you can log in with your administrative username and password. Enter your username password what you choose during installation process and then log in. Okay, so this is the home screen of your WordPress dashboard. So we have this big section here. We have quick links to do some tasks here. We have activity section. We have event and news section. On the left side, these are the important links from where we do all the work of WordPress. For example, to create posts, media, pages, commands, appearance, plugins, everything is on the left side. We're going to cover everything in detail from top to bottom in few minutes. But before we do that, we are going to clean this section so we do not distracted by this and we focus only these things. So these sections, you can choose the screen options and you can hide or show them. For example, if you want to hide them, you just uncheck them here and they will be hidden. Okay, so now our screen is clean. So we can focus directly here. Okay, so first of all, before we go into the main options on the left side, let's quickly see what are the options on the top. So here on the left side, there are some important links about WordPress. Here you can click and it will take you to the website front end and you can look after every change how your website looks. Then we have a comment link here. If you have new comments on your blog post, you can check them from here. Then we have a new link. You can add post, media, page and user from here. On the right side, you have admin section. Here is your username. You can change your picture. You can edit your profile and you can log out when you're finished working on your WordPress website. Okay, so now let's see all of them from top to bottom. So first thing is home. So if you're working on anything on a website and you want to come back to the home, you just click on home and you will be redirected here. Second thing is updates. So for now, I recently installed this WordPress, so I do not have any updates. But when you make a website after some time, you will have some plugin which required update, or you have theme which required updates. Also, right now I'm using WordPress version 5.4.2. In future, WordPress will release their newest version, so we have to install or update the recent version of WordPress. You can update everything from WordPress updates. After that, it is posts. You can click here and see all your posts on your website. If you want to add new posts, you can click here. You can add new post. You can create categories for your post and assign posts to the categories. For example, if you create a post about fashion, so you can create a category fashion and you assign all the posts to that category. You can create tags also for posts. After that, we have media. It is a library on our website where we have all the images used on website. You can add new images by clicking add new, and you can upload image, video, audio files, PDFs, any media from here. Then we have pages. If you click on all pages, it will show you all the pages on your website. If you want to add new page, you can click on add new. Just to explain you what is the difference between post and pages, I'll go back to front end of the website. Pages are the content type which we create one time and we use it for long time. For example, home is a page. About us, it can be a page where we put all information about our business or blog. Contact page, we can put a form here and people can come here and write us or contact us. Posts are the content which we publish time to time. For example, if you're a fashion blogger, you are adding new posts about fashion time to time. So those kind of content you can add as a post. If we go back to the website, this is a blog page and we have multiple posts on blog page. You can see I have new post demo, new post and another new post. So overall you can say a page can have multiple posts, but a post cannot have multiple pages. Okay, I hope this makes it some clear. Then after we have comment section, here you can see all the new comments, and then we have appearance section. The first thing is themes. So this section show you which theme is installed on your website. Right now I'm using 2020 theme. So you can see it here. If you want to add a new theme, you can click add new, and you can see there are thousands of free themes available on WordPress. You can sort them by popular themes. You can choose latest themes, or we have this filter here. You can choose the themes according to your requirement. For example, if you want to create a blog website, you can select blog and apply filter. And WordPress will show you all the themes available which are good for a blog website. If you want to make an e-commerce website, you can choose e-commerce theme, and WordPress will show you all the themes which are good for making e-commerce website. Next thing is customize. From here you can change a lot of things on a website. For example, from here you can select your website logo, and you can update new logo. And everything what you do in customizer, you can have a live preview here on right side. You can change colors on your website, background color, header and footer backgrounds. And there's some theme option also. You can use them to modify your website. Then we have cover template, background image, menus. You can manage all these menus from this section. You have widgets, homepage settings, and additional CSS. So all these options, they're different in different themes. For example, right now I'm showing you the example of WordPress 2020 themes. If you use any other theme, for example Astra or Avada or WP Ocean, you will have more options here, or maybe less options here. So depending on the theme, you can have different options here. After that, we have widget section. You can add different widgets here. For example, right now this theme supports two footer options. So you can add different widgets here. Depending on the theme, you can have more options here. You can have sidebar, and you can have more than two footer. You can have four footer options here. And then menus. You can add more pages to menus, or you can delete any item from here. For example, if I go and delete contact page, and after I save menu, then I go to back of website and refresh it, the menu is deleted from here. This thing you have to see, widgets, menus, background, you can also manage them from customize section also. There's the same section, there's just different places where you can navigate to these options. After we have plugin section, you can see all the installed plugin on your WordPress website. So just to explain you, plugin are some functionality which you can add on your website. If I want to add a new plugin for firewall, click add new and search for the plugin you want to install. You can type just relevant words and WordPress will show you all the example. So it show me here WordFence security, all-in-one WP security, Defender WordPress security. So typing here, you can choose any kind of plugin. For example, if I want to sell some products on my website, I'll search for WooCommerce, and WordPress will show you the plugins. So WooCommerce here, it is an open source e-commerce solution built on WordPress. You can sell products on your website if you use this plugin. And after your plugin editor, I recommend you do not edit this thing, because from here you can edit your plugin code. If you are a beginner, just avoid to use this section. After that, we have a user section. You can see all the users on your website. Right now I have only one user on my website, which is myself. Or you can add new users. You can give them privileges. You can add them as a subscriber or as an administrator also. And there are a bunch of different options here. Depends what privilege you want to give them on your website. Okay. And then you have your own profile. You can change your nickname. You can change your public display name. You can change your email address. Or you can change your password also. You can generate new password, and you can change your password from here. And then we have some tool section. So in tool section, you can import the data to a WordPress website. For example, you are importing post comments from a blogger blog, you can do that. If you want to import categories or anything, you can do that from here. Okay. And then after we export, if you want to export of your website content and you want to add it, or you want to import on another website, so you can export from here. Then we have site help. It is recently introduced on WordPress, so you can see if there is some issue on your website, Right now my website health is good, but I have a recommendation here that I'm not using HTTPS because it's a new site. That's why I'm not using HTTPS yet. Okay, so once I will be using HTTPS, this recommendation will be gone from here. And then you export personal data and erase personal data. And after, we have some settings here. First of all, we have general settings. So general setting, you can change your site title and tagline. You can change your WordPress URL and site URL, administrative URL, and there are other options here also. Okay, like you can change your date format, time format also. And then we have writing. Here you can change some post related settings. For example, if you want to make default post category, you can change it here. Right now I do not have more post categories, so it is uncategorized only here. For example, if you're a fashion blogger and you want to write a series of blogs about silk clothes, so you can add a category silk clothes and you can assign all the posts to that category. If you want to add a series of posts about shoes, so you can create a new category and you can assign all those posts related to shoes to that category. Okay, and after we have reading. So reading, you can decide whether the home page of your website displays the latest post or you can display specific page. So in my case, I am displaying the home page. If I go back and show you, so this is my home page. Because I created a page in backend which is home, if I want to choose another page, for example, if I want to choose about us page, I just go here, change it and save changes. Now I will go back to my WordPress homepage. So the page is changed. So basically you can change any page to be shown as your home page on your website. Then you can change your blog post page also. Right now, because I'm using blog page as my post page, so it is selected here. I can use any of the page here from here. And after, okay, so this is important. You should make sure that this option is unchecked, because if you check this option and save it, then after the search engine will not index your website on their search engine. For example, if you check this option, then Google bots will not list your website on Google search. Then we have discussion. Here you can set some settings about comments and posts or blogs, comment moderation. There are different settings here. You will take some time and you can understand what is everything here. And then we have some settings about media. So whenever you upload an image on your website, the WordPress create different version of the image. It create different thumbnail. You can define the width and height of thumbnail what WordPress will create for you. And then we have permalinks. Permalinks are your website URL structure. Many years before, we have URL structure like this, but now it is recommended to use structure like this. If you use structure like this, search engine will not favor your website very well. So always remember, you choose the post name, this structure, where you don't have like this question marks and equal, all these things on your website URLs. Okay, in the end, we have privacy here. You can select any privacy page. I do not have any privacy page, but when you will create a privacy page, you can select it here. Okay, and when you finish, just you can log out from here. Thank you so much. I hope this tutorial was useful. I made some another videos about how you can load your website in 1/2 second. I made a video about how you can install free SSL and make your website more secure. So go check out the other videos on my channel. Subscribe and like the channel. Share with your friends. In future, I'm going to make more videos about how to create websites, how to create blogs, and another useful stuff. Thank you.